And to understand it, it truly is to understand ourselves. So with that comes a new layer of consciousness, shall we say, which will include understanding why you have the dream, even though the imagery might be a new amalgamation of something you didn't think was real or possible or just really cool looking or whatever. But you'll understand why. You'll be able to look at each one of the components, the color, the shape, the size, the place, all these things, and understand why that was there. Because that's unique to you. That's who you are. I can give you techniques to understand how to interpret this information, but ultimately it's you're the one interpreting because it's your perceptions. So we have to remember that. So that's why these are simply techniques. No one can really tell you what your dreams mean because you're the one who dreamt it. It's your filters, your belief systems, and it's your experience. So, you know, there's stuff that can be obvious, you know, oh yeah, you're definitely talking about the real world out there. You know, a lot of people talk about precognitive dreams all the time. There's a lot of other stuff. I mean, there's remote viewing via dreams. There's a lot of different things you can do. But it's still your filters. So you have to understand that and why are your filters there. Where do they come from? Are they emotionally charged ones? Are they intellectually charged ones? Are they spiritually charged ones? You know, religiously? All these different things. So you have to understand that and understand yourself so that way you can really get a grasp of what this really means to you and your place in everything, in the world and the universe. That being said, your homework for this month is to start to construct your own dream sign. You're going to do this by identifying at least five things that you commonly see throughout your day. And you're going to ask yourself, why am I seeing this? What do I use this for? And is there any sentimental value? So do this with at least five things. The more details you can get, the better. And the more honest you are with yourself, the better. So that's very important to getting established in what you're actually seeing, your own sort of dream lexicon, if you will, and your own dream catalog of symbols. The other thing is what you're going to do is going to log at least 7 days worth of dream intentions and how you felt when you woke up. And that dream intention can be something as simple as like, I want to wake up feeling rested and invigorated. Doesn't matter, but make sure you write how you felt when you woke up, immediately when you woke up. And after a couple of minutes, and after you went, had your coffee, I mean like as soon as you wake up, as soon as you're like, I'm conscious in my body, in my bed, write down the very least of how you feel. If you had a dream experience, then by all means, please write that down too. But do it at least 7 times over this month. So what this is going to do is going to help you see the patterns within your conscious life and your subconscious. It'll give you another tool to calibrate why you're seeing stuff in your dream life and actually even why things are happening to you in your waking life, because it becomes a little more apparent when you have things written down, where your mind is, where your conscious mind is, what your intention is, and then what your subconscious like interprets that as, or even just does because of its day-to-day programming. Because what you're trying to do is get into this loop of the dream cycle so you can have a little bit more awareness during your mind consciousness. So that is your homework for this month, and there'll be much more, I'm sure, but we'll start there first.